don't care what they see, don't really bother me. I don't care what they say, there's got to be another way. I said, dream on, dreamer, dream on through the night. Dream on, dreamer.
We know that coming to high school sparks many important questions. One big question you may have is, what happens if I am disruptive to my class, and what are the consequences if I do so?
Okay, class, today we will be learning about feminism. Feminism refers to political, cultural, and economic movements aimed at protections for women. Feminism includes some of the sociological theories and philosophies concerned with issues of gender difference.
Lay off.
Come on, you're going to ISS right now. Let's go.
All right.
Yes, you are. Let's go. Come on. Let's go.
All right.
Mr. Schlegel, so if I was to disrupt class, what would happen to me?
Well, that's not a good thing, because you're here to learn, you know. Mm-hmm. And we don't want anybody that's... Well, I got a simple rule, all right? You don't disrupt the teacher from doing their job, and you don't disrupt the other kids from learning. Mm-hmm. All right? If either one of those two things happen, I'm going to get involved, the associate principal is going to get involved, and there's going to be consequences. First off, you're going to have to serve a detention with the teacher. You blow that off, that detention gets doubled. Again, it comes right back to me. You blow those off, they get doubled. So all of a sudden, one detention turns into two, two turns into four. It's better off not to goof off in class. You're here to learn.
So in other words, if you got to visit Mr. Schlegel or Mr. Schlegel has to visit you, it's not going to turn out good.
It's not a good thing.
So don't disrupt class. Thank you.
Okay, class, the first president of the United States was known as the father of his country. Who was it? A. Thomas Jefferson, B. Abraham Lincoln, C. George Washington, or D. Theodore Roosevelt? AJ.
C.
George Washington.
Yes. How many states make up the United States of America? A. 48, B. 52, C. 46, D. 50.
D50.
Blank is a country in South America. A. Russia, B. Argentina, C. Mexico, D. Japan, E. None of the above. AJ.
Argentina.
Everybody testing 1, 2, 3. Everybody, here goes. Nothing.
When you follow the rules and guidelines set at Bayport, it will make your experience here much more fun. You can enjoy the freedoms of being a high schooler and become a part of a journey that will allow you to explore a whole new environment. You will slowly become a respectable young adult and grow immensely from the moment you walk through the door as a freshman until the very last second of graduation as a senior. The catch is, it all starts with you and your actions. Disrupting class doesn't make for efficient work and only sets you back along with everybody else in the classroom. Being a respectful student is an asset that you and your peers can benefit from, and it will allow you to be the respectful young adult that lies within you.
Now
Yep, you're good.
Alright.
Yeah, Dan?
Alright, you're good. Go. Action. Alright.
Hey, Danny. So you've had experience with the disrupting class. What happens when you do so?
You're not going to be...
Do it again.
Watch as a wild AJ looks for a drink in the wild at Bayport High School. Oh, it's beautiful. It's beautiful. You don't get that kind of footage anywhere else except for at Bayport.
Ready to go.
Ah, no. Courtney. Okay, now go.
Hey Danny, you've had experience with this class. What happens when you do that?
They actually take you to a shut-down school. They beat you.
Alright, we're getting...